Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling. From glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the roses fallen. It's you, must go and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. I'll be here in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so. But if you come and all the flowers are dying, and I am dead, as dead I will may be, you'll come and find the place where I am lying, and kneel and say an Ave there for me. And I will know, though soft ye tread above me, and then my grave will richer, sweeter be. And you'll bend down and tell me that you love me. And I will rest in peace until you come to me.
Bill, what does St. Patrick's Day mean to you?
St. Patrick's Day means Ireland to me. It means Irish in Ireland. But I came from an Irish family. American Irish family.
Okay.
And they were really proud of being Irish. And they were second generation. My uncles were all, I'm third generation. They're all second generation. And, they loved being Irish. They were proud of it. And they were kind of like working class Irish. I used to say this about my relatives and who I love. But they would have this game. They played pinochle. And they'd come to our house and they set up two tables. And they put a bottle of Jameson in the middle of the table and they play drink or smell. And it'd be like, if you and I are partners and we win, just take a glass and break it. Decide to watch and say, smell it. They tell me it's fake Irish accent. They say, smell this, Dad, smell this, Lass. You're not a good keeper at the beer like we are. We get to drink, you get to smell it. You can smell it all night, you're gonna be smelling. I just enjoy that. And of course, you know, and after a couple of hands, even if you're good, you're gonna lose. And then they say, oh, we let you win those two. Because we feel so sorry for you. You get used to smelling it now. You're gonna be smelling it all night. And they go back and forth. You get really shit faced. This is my culture.
I love it.
We left Tulsa late one night, and the moon and the stars were shining bright, and everything went fine up that Tulsa hill. We were passing cars like they were stainless steel, when all of a sudden, with a blink of an eye, a Cadillac sedan went and passed me by. Well, the mark was made, there was a car with me, and the fellas started to tease me. So, I had to agree. He said, son, you're going to drive in the Dragon's Den. You don't get driving in a hot rod Lincoln. Not that bad. Yeah.
Yeah. And I missed some of your lines.
Don't punk me.
But